Yeah, well, the Tahoma is anchored about 2 miles off of the coast of Port-au-Prince, and the crew is treating the injured who are brought on board. Commander Jim Spott says that these are long hours. In fact, he paused for quite some time when we asked him when he arrived in Haiti, as if the days are just blurring together at this point. This is a picture of the Coast Guard's Tahoma, a 270-foot cutter from Portsmouth, now anchored 2 miles off the coast of Port-au-Prince. Commander Jim Spott says he can see the destruction from there.
A lot of buildings look like something off a cartoon, where the roof collapsed and all four walls had fallen out.
The commander says the injured lie everywhere. Makeshift hospitals are overwhelmed because it's still difficult to find qualified physicians to help. His crew is treating those too severely to be treated here, those lucky enough to be plucked from the crowd and driven by boat to the Tahoma. Commander Spott says his crew is bombarded with patients, all who are treated and then helicoptered to a hospital on the north side of the island.
We had everything from mechanics stitching people to information technology specialists and antibiotics.
And yet, in the middle of all the chaos, hope. This woman, who was crushed by a building, arrived at the Tahoma in serious condition. Her labor had stopped just as the baby's head had appeared. The crew thought it was stillborn. The crew planned to fly the woman out to save her life. But before she could get on the helicopter, her labor started again.
When she got to the ship, she started going to labor again, and the baby was born alive and healthy and pink.
The 5-pound healthy and pink baby boy weighs 5 pounds. That's typical, according to Spots, for birth weights in Haiti. The commander says mother and son were flown to the hospital together, and he expects them both to be okay. Commander Spott says he does not know how long the Tahoma will be stationed off of the coast of Haiti. He told us there's a saying in the military. They don't call them invitations, they call them orders. Live in the studio, I'm Josh Davis, WMUR News 9.